The purpose of Holocaust Memorial Day is to remember. Not only near unimaginable human cruelty, but near unimaginable human suffering and courage. So its purpose is to enable us to imagine, too, for memory needs imagination at its shoulder. The opposite of memory is forgetfulness. There is more than one kind of forgetfulness. There is the slow, accidental forgetfulness of weariness and inattention. And then there is the deliberate forgetfulness of disbelief. Ours is an age of denial. The cancellation of the past that was Pol Pot's return to year zero was not the 20th century's only attempt to expunge history. And this century seems to have learnt little from the terrible experiences of the last. Whatever our politics, we censor, we cancel, we airbrush, we no platform, we deny. That which we don't want to have happened, we insist did not happen. Make it go away, we beg our parents when we are children. And the more childish we remain, the greater our demands on politicians, teachers, commentators to tell us the lies we prefer to the truth. Those who try to make what they don't like go away are aided by the very resource we once thought could be relied upon to deliver truth. With what hopefulness we greeted the advent of the internet. Now, we said, everything could be verified and nothing denied. There was no limit to what we could find out. History awaited us at the touch of a key. But the opposite has turned out to be the case. That same internet, along with all the rumour and anxiety sites it facilitates, social media, chat rooms, Twitter, has become our greatest source of disinformation. And if events unfolding before our very eyes can be flatly denied, how much more precarious is the past? More than ever are we thrown back on memory. Never forget was the grave injunction delivered to humanity as the truth of what had happened in the camps began to be told. This was the call that went beyond questions of forgiveness or even understanding. It was a bald commandment, just let it be remembered. In a harrowing passage in Primo Levi's magisterial If This Is a Man, the greatest of all depictions of death in life in a concentration camp, Levy describes a dream he shares with fellow inmates. He dreams he is back home, telling people of his experiences, but they are, and I quote, completely indifferent, speak confusedly of other things among themselves, as if I was not there. Again and again, guards taunted Levy with that prospect, the ever-repeated scene of the unlistened-to story. And even if those returning from the camps did succeed in getting people to listen, they could not get them to believe. It was partly knowing they would not be believed, either because what they had to tell was barely believable, or because they feared that malice would shut the ears of listeners that kept so many survivors silent for so long. Eventually, one by one, they found the courage to refute those guards, deny their own nightmares, and tell the story of what had happened to them. They were right to fear malice. Holocaust denial is a vocation for some who call themselves historians. Making it not have happened is their life's work. Their motives are various, but for none of them is the denial benign. None claims to be the bearer of good news to the Jews. None is saying, rejoice, I have the evidence. More of you survived than you think. For many, indeed, denial of the Holocaust coexists with the wish it had been even worse. Show the Holocaust to have been a hoax, and you demonstrate why Jews deserved to suffer it. This assault on memory is carefully calibrated to denigrate not just the victims, not just individual Jews, whether they were in the camps or not, but Jewish culture and history. For Jews, memory is survival and continuance. an unsettled, peripatetic people, they carry their history around with them, in memory. They are who they are because they remember to be. But to do violence to the memory of one people amounts to doing violence to the memory of everyone. No story is just the story of itself. One will always beget another, just as one lie will always beget another. So when those prison guards scoffingly warned Primo Levi that his story would be unheard, they were presaging a world where truth and falsehood would be relative, and deafness would one day be universal. It is a matter of life and death, therefore, that we remember.
Thank you. Thank you. Messer tepta coscin nas nosis hem nebeti voci, so thank you.